Good morning, children. I hope you all are safe at your home. This is class 10th subject English, topic reported speech. This is chapter 8 in grammar book and this is lecture number 5. In first lecture we learnt about general rules. Then in second lecture we learnt about the rules of converting assertive sentences from direct to indirect speech. In third lecture, we learnt how to change interrogative sentences from direct speech to indirect speech. Then in fourth lecture, we learnt how to convert optative and exclamatory sentences from direct to indirect. So this is lecture 5th. In this lecture we are going to learn how to change imperative sentences from direct into indirect. So let us begin. So the topics to be covered today, first of all recapitulation, then conversion of imperative sentence and sentence beginning with let, and then we shall discuss some examples. So let us start. In previous lecture we learnt how to change the optative sentence and exclamatory sentence also from direct to indirect. We learnt the rules like reporting verb sad will be changed into wished or prayed in optative sentences. Then we use the conjunction that, and then optative sentence will be changed into assertive one. Exclamatory sign will be removed and at the end we shall use full stop. Then we discussed some examples as well. After that we learnt how to change exclamatory sentences from direct to indirect. Sad or sad to will be changed into exclaimed with joy or exclaimed with sorrow or exclaimed with surprise according to the sense. If these exclamatory words are given like aha, ha, hooray, so there we use exclaimed with joy. If the words aha, alas, these words are given, then we use exclaimed with sorrow. And if what and how these words are given, then we use exclaimed with surprise. And we remove what and how, in place of what and how we use very or great. Here also we use conjunction that, and once again the same rule that any sentence, whether it is interrogative, exclamatory or optative, will be changed into assertive form. Exclamatory sign will be removed and we use full stop at the end of the sentence. So this we read, this we understood in previous lecture. So children, let us start imperative sentences today. Imperative sentences express command, request, advice, order. So let us learn how to change from direct to indirect speech. So first rule is about change in reporting verb. Reporting verb is changed in imperative sentences into requested or advised or ordered or asked or commanded, or it can be changed into urged. So reporting verb will be changed according to the sense. If there is a request, then requested, if there is an advice, then advised, if there is an order, then order. So accordingly you have to change the reporting verb. So the next rule, it is that imperative word. Next rule is imperative word is changed into to infinitive. We use to infinitive. Next is, we do not use any conjunction. No conjunction is used. Now let us discuss examples. After rules, then we shall learn it in a better way. The headmaster said to the peon, "Bring me the attendance register." So here you can see this reported speech, "Bring me the attendance register." This is in imperative form. This is imperative sentence. So we shall follow the rules accordingly. So the headmaster said to the peon, "Bring me the attendance register." So here the headmaster is ordering the peon. That's why we are going to write, the headmaster ordered the peon. Now see, this said to is changed into ordered. According to the sense, we have changed the reporting verb. The peon, now these inverted commas will be removed, and here we shall write to infinitive is used. To bring, now this is me is first person, and first person will be changed according to the subject. Subject is the headmaster. So it will be the peon to bring him the attendance register. So this is the way to change the imperative sentence into indirect speech. So these inverted commas will be removed. Now next example. It is, an old man said to Vikas, "Please help me." So it will be, an old man. Now it is the word please. So it means here is a request. So the old man requested, said to will be changed into requested. Requested Vikas, inverted commas will be removed, and in place of please, already we have written requested, so this will be removed. Here to infinitive, to help. Now this is given me, so me will be changed into him, because this is first person, and first person is changed according to subject. Subject is an old man. Help him, at the end, full stop, no inverted commas. Now next example. It is, a doctor said to him, "Avoid unhealthy food." So how to change it? The doctor has actually advised him. So the doctor advised him. Now to infinitive, to avoid unhealthy food. at the end, full stop. So this is the way to change imperative sentences from direct to indirect speech. So once again, see it. The doctor said to is changed into advised, because here the doctor is advising him to avoid. To infinitive is used to avoid unhealthy food, and at the end inverted commas will be removed. Now let us discuss some more examples of imperative sentences. The teacher said to the boys, do not make a noise. So here the teacher said to. Said to will be converted into order. The teacher ordered the boys, comma, inverted commas will be removed. Now here it is given do not. Do not is changed into not to. The teacher ordered the boys not to make a noise. Full stop at the end. Now, one more example. He said to me, please take your book. So here the word please is given. It is expressing that it is a request. So he requested me to take. Now this is given your. Your is second person, and second person is changed according to the object. Fine. So it will be as it is given. He said to me, please take your book. So he requested me to take my book, and at the end full stop. So I hope you have understood the rules of changing imperative sentences from direct speech to indirect speech. Now let us move ahead. Now the next heading, next topic, it is sentences beginning with let. So now we are going to learn how to change these sentences into indirect speech. So there are some specific rules. So let us discuss. First of all, if let expresses a proposal, then reporting verb, then how to change the reporting verb? Reporting verb is changed into proposed. Fine. And let is replaced by should. So let expresses different meanings. So if let expresses a proposal, then the reporting verb is changed into proposed, and let is changed into should. Now let us discuss some examples so that we can understand it in a better way. So first example is, I said to my friends, let us go out for a walk. So let us start. How to write? I proposed to, there will be proposed to. I proposed to my friends that we will use here conjunction that we should go out for a walk. Full stop. So here sad is changed into proposed to my friends. Then the conjunction that is used, let word will be removed, and in place of let we use should. So us is changed into we, that we should go out for a walk. So this is the way to change it. Now next example. Mohan said to me, let us wait for the next train. So how to write? Mohan proposed to me that, once again same we, then let is changed into should if it expresses proposal, that we should wait for the next train. So these are the examples of sentences beginning with let, and if let expresses a proposal, so this is the way to change the sentence from direct to indirect speech. Now the next meaning of let. If let denotes permission, then how to change such sentences? Then there let is changed into the phrase, let will be changed into the phrase might be allowed, or simply we can change into the infinitive to let. Means such kind of sentences can be changed into two ways. If let denotes permission, there we change the let into might be allowed, or simply we can change the sentence using to infinitive. So to understand it in a better way, let us discuss some sentences. First sentence is, he said to the peon, let the visitors come in. So this sentence can be changed into two ways. So first I am going to write, and then second I will tell you. So first, he ordered the peon. Here we are going to change the reporting verb according to the sense. He ordered the peon that. Here we shall use a conjunction that the visitors, or the visitor. I told you that let is changed into might be allowed. So the visitor might be allowed to come in. So this is the first way to change such a sentence. He ordered the peon that the visitor might be allowed to come in. This is the one way. And in other way we can write, he ordered the peon to let the visitor come in. Like imperative sentences, we can also change it. Here just we can put to. He ordered the peon to let the visitor come in. So these are the two ways, either by using might be allowed or by using to infinitive like imperative sentence. Now next example. The boy said to them, let me work now. So how to change it? You can simply change it like imperative sentence, like the boy, here the boy is actually requesting. So the boy requested them, simply to infinitive, to let. Now this me will be changed into the boy, means him. Same case is used, to let him work, and now is changed into them at the end, full stop. So this is another way, the boy requested them to let him work then. I hope you are understanding. Now one more example, such sentence. The headmaster said to the peon, let this boy go out. So the headmaster ordered the peon, simply we can change it like imperative sentence, the headmaster ordered the peon to let that boy go out, full stop at the end. So this is the way to change the sentence, to change the these sentences beginning with let. So this sentence can be changed in other way also. Then we can write, the headmaster ordered the peon that the boy might be allowed to go out. So in two ways we can change these sentences. If let denotes permission, so these are the rules. When let denotes permission, there we change let into might be allowed, and there we use conjunction that. Otherwise in other way we just use to infinitive. In that way also we can change the sentence. Now next part, if let expresses condition or supposition, then it is changed into, then it let will be changed into might, and the reporting verb, this will be changed into might, and the reporting verb remains unchanged. There will be no change in reporting verb. So let us discuss one example. It is, the teacher said, let him work ever so hard, he cannot pass the examination. So how to change it? The teacher said that, I told you this reporting verb will remain same. Said that will be used, that he could not pass. He could not, here this sentence first we have taken, can will be changed into could. He could not pass the examination the examination. However, hard, however hard he might work. So this is the way to change it. The teacher said that he could not pass the examination. Could not pass the examination. However hard, so hard is given. However hard he might work. When this is the rule to change in such a way, when let expresses a condition or supposition, there let will be changed into might. So students, I hope you have understood whatever has been taught to you today. So now let us talk about your homework. Your homework is to read all the rules of imperative sentences, as we have done today. That in imperative sentences, we change the reporting verb into requested, advised, ordered, asked, etc. according to the sense it is changed. Imperative word is changed into to infinitive. Then no conjunction is used. Then we discussed some examples. After that, we read about sentences beginning with let. First rule, if let expresses a proposal, their reporting verb is changed into proposed. Means proposed to. To is also used. Then let is changed into should. Then we discussed some examples. After that, we read about this rule of let. If let denotes permission, then let is changed into might be allowed, or we can change, or we can use to infinitive. We can change the sentence in this manner also. In next we learned if let expresses condition or supposition, then let is changed into might, and this is the way, this example we have done, this is the way to change such sentence. So in homework you are supposed to read all these rules and do the questions or exercises given on EdQuark. I hope you have understood each and everything. Thank you.